What are some cool physiological acts? These are the tricks we can apply to our daily life habits and to influence and change people. People will not know that you are using physiological acts to control them. So, these are the physiological acts we can apply on people. 1. If someone is angry with you and you keep calm, they may be more angry, but then they shall be ashamed of themselves. You just be calm and be looking at him or her. Don't beg too much, because if you beg, his emotion feeling arise. Just keep calm. Don't talk or say anything. The person will realize himself and come back to normal, and he or she will be ashamed and walk away mourning. Just like an adage that say, silence is the best answer for a fool or talkative. 2. If someone keeps talking and you can't get in the conversation or you can't follow up with them, you drop something on the ground like key, pen, etc. You bend down to pick it up and start talking. In this way, you can interrupt the other party without being noticed. This is very simple. You and your friends are talking and you don't understand or you can't keep going with them in that conversation. And it will be funny and a shame for you to say, please, can you repeat what you said? Or did you said something? Your friend may look at you in a bad manner or ignore you and continue their conversation. You just drop something like pen, key, stone, and many other things. If you do this, they will keep quiet and wait for you and start the conversation again. Very simple. 3. If someone is bothering you at your desk all the time, keep talking to him, but get up and walk back to his seat or desk together. There was a boss who was good at this before. He would talk you back to your seat and desk, and then you wonder how I came back. If you are working at a company or any place, then one of your workers or members usually come to sit and disturb you with noise or gossip. Worse, did you know what he will do? Continue talking with him or her, and then stand up from your own seat and walk together with the person back to his own seat. He or she will remain there, then come back to your own seat and continue your work. This also occurs in the school. Your friends disturbing you in the class, if your friend comes to your own seat, walk with him or her back to his own seat and then come back to your own seat. So cool. 4. When a group of people laugh, everyone look at their own favorite person. It is true. When everybody laughs, you look at your wife, children, your girlfriend, or crush, even your family. When a group of people laugh, everyone will look at their favorite person. 5. Before the interview, arrive at the interview place in advance time and chat with strangers for 20 minutes. This will make your brain feel familiar with the environment, which will make you more confident. In fact, talking to a stranger before interview will give you clues to your success. 6. If you suddenly think of the ugliness that happened years ago and feel very shameful, stop and think about the person who saw it. You can remember the ugliness that happened to him. Not at all. Similarly, no one will remember your humiliating moments. 7. If you have no motivation to learn a new skill, maybe an instrument or foreign language or anything, tell yourself, okay, I'll sit down and learn for 5 minutes. Most of the time, you end up sitting for more than 5 minutes. Even if you only sit for 5 minutes, it is better than not trying. 8. People associate with you with adjectives you use on other people. This phenomenon is called unconscious vicious transfer. That is to say, if you say that a person is sincere and kind, people will also associate this quality with you. If you always speak of ill or bad of others behind your back, people also associate with this negative comment with you. Criticize a person of a bad habit, he or she will behave badly to you. 9. If you feel someone is looking at you, you can look at your clothes, wash, or the shoe you wear, or turn around and look at anything else. If the person is looking at you, we will also subconsciously look at what we are looking to. Very simple. 10. If you are anxious in conversation and eye contact make you feel stressed, you can try to look in the middle of each other's eyes. It makes you feel friendly and confident.